Here we will show you how to create BK7231 development board. Our development board will be created from NodeMCU board, which can be cheaply bought online for as low as $3. We are going to use the fact that common ESP12 module has a very similar footprint to WB3S and CB3S modules. You can see the pinout on the screen. As you can see, the ground, 3.3 volts, ADC, and even UART and reset signals are in the same place. This means that we can replace ESP module with BK. Unfortunately, the ESP module has quite a lot of pads, so we will have to use hot air in order to desolder that. Okay, let's start with adding flags to the pads. Flags will make soldering easier. Then add some PB solder to the pads. The PB solder will mix with the PB3 solder, which was used by the factory, and it will lower the melting point of the joints. Finally, it's time to do some heating. Now you have to heat up the whole board slowly and evenly. Please be patient and wait for the solder joints to melt. Add more flux if needed. It can really take few minutes before the module is ready for removal. Once the solder is melted, pick up the module, but do not use force, otherwise you may rip off the PCB tracks with the module. Okay, the module is removed now. Finally, it's time to clear the pads with a solder wick. You can also clean the PCB with isopropyl alcohol. Now we assume that you already have a CB3S or W3S module. You can buy one online or just get one from IoT device and replace it with ESP. You don't need hot air to solder this module. It can be easily soldered with cheap soldering iron. Just add some solder to one pad and then use this pad to hold the module in place and position it correctly. Make sure that all pads are aligned. Then, as always, add some flux and finally solder the pads one by one. When soldering, make sure to heat up the pad with a soldering iron tip and then apply solder to the pad. It's very easy, as long as you keep your soldering iron tip clean. Use a proper PB solder with low melting temperature and also make sure to use flux. You can add more flux if it's needed. Finally, all pads are soldered. Now you need to clean the board from the flux residue. It can be easily done with a PCB cleaner. Okay, the soldering is now finished. We have used this method to create two BK7231 development boards, one with N version, second with T. Here is the pin mapping from this board, so you know which GPIO is which. The flashing procedure for this board is very simple. Just start our BK flash tool and press the button while it's waiting for getting bus. The development board can be used for many interesting projects. Here is an example showing what we are working on right now. Our board has currently a MAX7219 dot matrix display connected, which can print time received from the web over the NTP protocol. It also has an IR receiver, so we can use TV remote to control our home assistant automations. It also has multiple SPI memory chips with SOP to DIP converters. It also has a second display connected, the 6 digits, 7 segment, one with a simple 2-wire interface. We also have a potentiometer connected to ADC pin and DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. Stay tuned to see this board used in our future projects. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please visit our forum. You can also consider visiting our IoT devices teardowns list or even submit a new device there. We can send you a free gift for that. See you on Electroda!